So I'm back again at the Mogla camp, and as usual, there's lots of stuff to fix here.
So we had all these lawn chairs set up for my brother's wedding, these ones and then some. And while we had them all out there, I noticed quite a lot of them have a bit of rot on them. So there's some rot here, and here. This one I've already fixed. This one in the back. This one here. This one, I wasn't sure if it was rotten, so I just whacked it real hard, and I guess it was. And more busted ones. So most of these lawn chairs have actually been exposed to the weather for 30 summers now. So they're doing really good, and except for those rotten bits, they're mostly still good. So flipping this one over, the frame on the bottom, the legs and these parts, these are made out of cedar, so they don't rot very much. And surprisingly, in here, joints like this, that's often where a lot of rot occurs, but my dad glued these together with Weld Bond, and it seems to be fairly effective at keeping the moisture out, and therefore keeping the rot out. Still looking pretty good underneath here. And for all the safety critics out there, this time there's nothing unsafe about my footwear. So this one does have a bit of rot in the frame. It's always these tight joints where moisture can really get trapped, like in here. And once the moisture gets in, it doesn't easily evaporate. Now some people often suggest you should just use wood sealer to seal that moisture out. But the moisture will always get in, and the wood sealer prevents the moisture from getting out, so it's not really a win. The thing you should always avoid is large joint areas, like in here for example. This is just an area where a lot of crap can get in there, and this has gotten fairly rotten in here. You can actually approximate a roundover quite well just with a few strokes of a flat hand plane at different angles. And if you do enough, it's like a multi-segmented arc, and just with a bit of sanding, it can be completely round. That saw doesn't track straight enough for the rip fence to be any use, so I'm just marking it for cutting it freehand. Well, some of that wood only came off in splinters, but the chairs are all done now. That chop saw and the bandsaw sure came in handy. The chop saw came out of the garbage, the only thing that was wrong was a loose arbor nut. And this bandsaw was given to me for free by a friend because it was broken. And I had to improvise a new tire with electrical tape. It comes with a rip fence as well, but it tracks too poorly for that to be of any use. So considering some of these chairs have lasted 30 years of weather exposure, I figure they should be good for at least another 10, maybe 15 years.